What comes to mind with the phrase smart borders for seamless trade, travel and transport? If you guessed customs, you're correct. Today, join the rest of the world in observation of International Customs Day and discover more about its processes and procedures. Plus,
I received a tertiary scholarship from PRT to attend the University of Technology, Jamaica. It meant a lot to me because I realized that somebody else believed in me.
We'll hear how one of the island's partners is assisting young Jamaicans to be a part of the vision to make our island the place of choice to live, work, raise families, and do business. I'm Adrian Atkinson. Keep watching. How much do you really know about the Jamaica Customs Agency, aside from collecting a barrel or two or clearing goods? If that's all you know about their work, this next feature will provide you with some new information.
The mandate of customs is to facilitate trade, protect Jamaica's borders, optimize revenue collection, deliver high-quality customer service, and develop and maintain a team of motivated, professional, and competent staff.
The Jamaica Customs Agency, JCA, is ensuring that Jamaicans are aware of all the happenings at customs through their public education engagement sessions, Customs Meets the Community. For the fourth stop in the series, Customs was in the Garden Parish of St. Anne.
Now embodied in our mission statement is the provision of high quality customer service. And part of how we are going to achieve this is to ensure that we expand and enhance the channels through which we communicate with you. And this is one such method.
For the first engagement in May 2017 in St. Elizabeth, importing personal, commercial, restricted, prohibited and infringing goods and the processes and procedures for returning residents were among the topics on the agenda. The JCA works with various border control and regulatory agencies, and in August, citizens of Spanish Town and its environs learnt about importing and exporting plant products from one such agency, the Plant Quarantine Division of the Ministry of Industry, Commerce, Agriculture and Fisheries. Incentives and the processes for importing charitable items were also discussed. Portlanders in November received information on how to register a charity with a presentation from the Department of Cooperatives and Friendly Societies. The Pesticides Control Authority, another regulatory partner of the JCA, was also on hand to present information on the importation of pesticides.
Do we have any operators of duty-free shops in here?
Ocho Rios is one of the tourist hubs on the island where visitors engage in duty-free shopping. And so for the St. Anne leg, establishing duty-free shops was on the agenda.
First of all, to be a duty-free operator, you have to be approved by customs. You have to be licensed by customs. So you have to be an approved entity, right? So you can't just get up tomorrow morning and say you're setting up a duty-free shop. You have to tell us the items that you intend to stock in a duty-free shop. And you have to pay for your license, of course, in the form of check. And it is the equivalent of the US dollar amount, which is US $4,000. And if you have additional shops, per shop you pay US $1,000.
In addition to this, letters stating the particulars of the directors of the company and a floor plan for the shop should be submitted during the application process. Other documents to be submitted include a general bond for the warehousing of goods, as well as certified copies of the constitution of the company. The agency is in consultation with various stakeholders to make legislative changes as it relates to repealing and replacing the old Customs Act. Through the proposed changes, access to information and conducting business with the agency will be improved.
There are a number of things that we want to do with our new legislative reform program. One of the things that we want to do is to ensure that you have the information that you need in order for you to be able to do business with us. So you need to know what are the laws in relation to a particular matter. We're committing that we're going to tell you.
They're geared to create, build, and reward farmers or enterprises in agriculture to improve and expand their production.
Farmers can receive 20% duty concession on farm vehicles, raw materials used in farming, as well as remission of duties on agricultural equipment, machinery, and products.
The farmer applies through RADA. RADA writes a letter on the farmer's behalf, explaining that this farmer is a bona fide farmer, and then we then write a letter to the commissioner of the Jamaica Customs Agency. They do their checks, and then the imports are processed on the Asecura platform system at Jamaica Customs Agency. So whenever you actually access this incentive in the future, if you plan to import again, you do not have to go through the process of the ministry.
Want more information about receiving agricultural incentives? Contact the Ministry of Industry, Commerce, Agriculture and Fisheries. You can get additional information on the establishment of duty-free shops by contacting the Jamaica Customs Agency.
In case you missed it, next we have a roundup of the major news stories coming out of the government this week.
Hi there, I'm Simone Wolf with your JIS News of the Week. The latest business and consumer indices show high confidence in the Jamaican economy. Commissioned by the Jamaica Chamber of Commerce, the figures for the fourth quarter of 2018 were released on Tuesday by researcher Don Anderson.
There is a consolidation of the level of confidence amongst the business sector and amongst the consumers with regard to the economy and the way things are going for their businesses. So this is in fact the very first indication. There has been a continuation of this upward tick from last year, last quarter 2017 to the last quarter 2018, over the last five quarters certainly.
Cabinet, led by Prime Minister Andrew Holness, met this week to plan the national budget for the 2019-2020 fiscal year, which begins April 1. The meetings followed a three-day cabinet retreat to review the country's performance in 2018 and discuss numerous issues of national interest. Meanwhile, Prime Minister Andrew Holness is encouraging Jamaicans to participate in the just-launched Jamaica Social Investment Exchange, J6. Five social enterprises, the Agency for Inner City Renewal, Def Can Coffee, Praise Jamaica, Choose Life International and Alpha School of Music, have been vetted and approved by the JSC to raise funds on the online platform.
These companies are good entities for which to put your giving, your philanthropic giving to. And I would encourage, I endorse this, and I encourage all Jamaicans to participate by giving to these companies.
The Office of Utilities Regulations, OUR, says it has secured almost $1 million in compensation payment for utility customers. The figures were contained in the entity's quarterly performance report for the July to September period of 2018. The Ministry of Health is advising persons to seek medical attention immediately after experiencing warning symptoms of dengue fever, including lethargy, restlessness, persistent vomiting, pain in the abdomen, signs of bleeding, and loose stool.
Those signs of bleeding can include bleeding from the gums, bleeding in the urine, and can be bleeding in the stool. Usually though, when you start getting bleeding in the stool, in the urine and stuff, you have reached a severe point. But from you have warning signs that we describe, you must go to your private or public health facility. See the doctor, because it means that you must be in a facility where you can be monitored.
The Jamaica Defense Force now has permanent accommodations in Western Jamaica. National Security Minister Dr. Horace Chang says the soldiers based at the barracks located at the Sangster International Airport will assist police in St. James, Hanover and Westmoreland.
We intend to maintain a high level of security presence. So even though they may not have the same powers or the extensive powers, we're going to maintain security presence in Montego Bay. The government is committed to ensuring the safety of our citizens.
Several Hanover communities are now benefiting from a $30 million hot mix patching program targeting 10,000 square meters of roadway across the parish. The National Works Agency is doing the work, which began earlier this month and is expected to be completed in February. $25 million have been set aside for the initial work to set up a reggae museum in the country.
We have to build out the capacity of reggae to drive 24/7 experiences in different locations across Jamaica.
This launch takes on special significance because it's a grand celebration party for the recent inscription of reggae music of Jamaica to the UNESCO list of intangible treasures for the whole of humanity.
And finally, licensed primary in St. Thomas and Manchester-based New Forest Infant Primary and High School have received $8 million each to purchase a school bus.
Today's agreement requires the commitment of all stakeholders at the school community national levels to see that investment in these schools lead to better educational outcomes for our children.
This signing ceremony indicates a genuine commitment by the people and the government of Japan to assist Jamaica to further enhance the education for its young citizens who fulfill their dream of a better tomorrow with hope.
And those were some of the stories making news this week. I'm Simone Wolf.
I will give them an 8 because I've known that they have a hard task to do, especially in the Christmas season. You know, they have a hard task to do, and they always have leniency and peepers.
I'd rate them at 7.
Give them a 4 because they need to improve on their time.
They were slow.
It's my mom who had to do stuff, and she's an elderly, and it took her like practically the whole day.
6. My experience, for me, the service is good.
But I give them a 8% still, because you can't be too hard upon them, you know. A good people them. Sometimes them take long for deal with the thing, but sometimes, you know, them deal with the thing quick.
The European Union is one of our biggest trade partners, but they are not only concerned with the exchange of goods, they are also vested in the development of our people. One of the many initiatives is the poverty reduction program, targeting residents of volatile communities.
I wanted to be an educator because I believe that education is the most powerful weapon that can change the world.
My dreams and aspiration is to one day become an entrepreneur where I can employ other persons and help to build the country.
I wanted to go into development. I wanted to help people become better versions of themselves. Growing up, I saw a lot of violence, I saw a lot of crime, I saw a lot of poverty. The challenges are so many. The first one that comes to mind is the level of youth unemployment that's here.
challenges that exist here in West Prospect Bogwalk are lack of awareness for educational opportunities or job opportunities.
Not many got a chance to do CXC or graduate from the secondary level. So that's a major setback for the people living in the community.
A way to alleviate this issue is training programs. They need more opportunities, like to go back to school, to get themselves a certificate so they can be able to work and create employment for themselves and their family.
Push more entrepreneurship opportunity. Encourage these youths to be creative and innovative in what they do. Give them startup capital to start their business. Invest more in the youth skills and talents.
The Poverty Reduction Program is funded by the European Union, and it really is a program that focuses on the most vulnerable type of communities, making communities safer, making citizens more healthy, better access to education.
For European Union, investing in youth is an obvious choice. They are the future of the country. If we prepare them well, they will bring the change that Jamaica needs. That's why we invest in scholarships, internship, training, in life skills and mentorship.
I received a tertiary scholarship from PRT to attend the University of Technology, Jamaica. It meant a lot to me because I realized that somebody else believed in me and somebody saw the potential that I have. And somebody believed that I could actually achieve my goal.
I benefited by getting, firstly, an internship, and also they assisted my bachelor's degree financially. But critically, outside of the finances, the persons that were on the project, you know, the motivation that they provided, etc., it really provided a huge boost.
This is my third year at the MICO. This scholarship, it helped me to be able to focus only on my education here, because tertiary education is not cheap.
I was placed at ODPEM on the one-year internship program. It was really good. It was an opportunity for me to prove myself, to give myself of service, and also to gain experience in the working world, and to also provide for my family.
I plan to be an agent of change in my community by being a mentor, a leader, and a godfather for the youths growing up. Try to help them teach them a trade.
You don't have to be rich to help. You don't have to achieve greatness to start. I contributed to my basic school by providing them with the necessary resources that they need, that I believe that in the long run, it will have a ripple effect on many, many persons.
Professionally, I manage the whole program, which is aimed at giving young persons the opportunity to, you know, do what I did, basically, to get their foot inside an organization. Additionally, I also have a little small business that I try to employ young persons to learn a skill, etc.
When you're persistent in life, when you're determined, when you're hungry for success, then you'll be able to accomplish and achieve anything that you want.
It has changed hundreds and hundreds of lives. Not just my life, my family life, my friends' lives, etc. I want to just urge everyone looking on to continue these social programs. These are the solutions to the many ills that we face as a society and as a country and even as a world. So thank you, and I challenge you, continue it. It's needed.
Getting out there and experiencing the world is oftentimes the prescription for living your best life. I agree completely. Don't be beset by onism, which is the frustration of being stuck in just one body, which inhabits only one place at a time. Make it so that onism is more of a realization of how little of the world you have experienced, and start putting things in place to start your adventure. After all, the world in its whole is yours. Now we venture to Montego Bay, and the good news is that you won't even have to leave your seat as we make a virtual stop at the Sangster International Airport for the opening of a new air traffic control tower.
The Jamaica Civil Aviation Authority welcomes you to our modern state-of-the-art air traffic control facility at the Sangster International Airport.
It endorses and underscores the commitment of the Government of Jamaica and the Airports Authority and the Jamaica Civil Aviation Authority to develop a world-class aviation industry.
Today represents an important milestone in the civil aviation history with the opening of the new Sangster International Airport Air Traffic Control Tower. This undertaking forms part of the Government of Jamaica comprehensive $4.92 billion modernization program.
The new SIA tower comprises essential components of the Air Navigation Services Modernization Program. This has allowed the JCAA to enhance the safety, efficiency, and reliability of its air traffic services.
It promises to significantly boost Jamaica's air navigation service delivery. The tower will greatly enhance confidence, reliability, efficiency of our air navigation system as Jamaica continues to provide safe and assured service to airlines that navigate our airspace.
The tower is an eight-sided structure, approximately 122 feet or 37 meters above ground level.
We have a space to ourselves, that's one. When we're coming in, we're not trying to be hustling and bustling through tourists or any other staff. We have a lounge area, which helps us to become a little bit more relaxed so that when we're actually on the sector, we are more focused and we are able to do our jobs that much better.
Line up at White Runway 07, Southwest 1113.
With the industry's hallmarks being innovation and the conveyance of progress, we must continuously devise ways to exponentially increase our safety and value while increasing the efficiency, overall performance, and utility of the industry for the nations, peoples, and the world at large which we serve.
We have expanded the training institute for air traffic controllers. We have three ground radar stations, one in Kingston, one in Montego Bay, and one in Manchester, so that the investment in the human resource to run all of the equipment that has been bought. The Sangster International Airport is our main tourist gateway. Some 4.2 million passengers transited this facility over the last year, and we intend to increase that this year to approximately 5 million. As a result of the equipment that we have here now and this new tower, it is going to enhance safety, it is going to underline Jamaica's reputation of a safe airspace.
This new ATM environment, which is comprised of both the Sangster and NMIA towers, as well as supporting infrastructure and technologies, has positioned Jamaica as a leading air traffic management environment with the most advanced equipment available on the market to improve the safety of air operations nationally and globally.
So Jamaica is known as the Singapore of the West in terms of our connectivity, in terms of air or sea route. And Jamaica will now facilitate other airlines. So even if the airline doesn't land here, because they are now transiting our airspace, we are going to be earning more. It's now easier for them to travel in a straight line, going to South America or from South America, going across, or even from Europe coming into this region.
I say we're winning right now. We forget that trophy to what we're living right now. We are the structures that we're building right now, yeah. Are we chilling right now? Oh, yes, we're winning right now. Our Thanksgiving right now, yeah. I said we're winning right now, say we. Oh, yes, we're winning. I want to hear you say we win it. Oh yes, Jamaica.
Our brand promises of safety, efficiency, and innovation are strong and evident. They are promises to which the world has grown accustomed to, and promises we must keep.
So as we take to the skies, may our flights be smooth. May our landings be safe, so that Jamaica may increase in beauty, fellowship, and prosperity.
This is where our sojourn ends for today. If you enjoy the show, tell a friend. Let them know that they can watch this and other programs by visiting our YouTube channel or our website. We do it for the love, but we love to see those likes on our social media pages. On behalf of the entire team here at the GIS, I'm Adrian Atkinson. Do enjoy the rest of your Saturday.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.